Jerk, sponsored by Terry Lambert Hyundai.
Well, it's going to be a stormy Wednesday morning. We're tracking some storms headed our way with widespread showers. Stay with us for the latest.
Now, on this Channel 6 at 6, reviewing Augusta's exotic dancing ban. Why some city leaders want to strip away the rule.
Also ahead, creating a new city in Augusta. Why some want Somerville to break away.
And Christmas time is finally here. Why it's more important than ever to put money in those red kettles. As your news at 6 starts now.
Live from Television Park. This is WJBF News Channel 6 at 6.
Good evening, everybody. I'm Brad Means.
And I'm Jenny Montgomery. Thanks so much for joining us. Coverage you can count on begins with Augusta commissioners directing the planning department to review the city's exotic dancing code.
Now a commission committee is recommending steps to make it less restrictive. News Channel 6's George Escala has the story.
Adult nightclubs are not everyone's cup of tea, but Augusta commissioners considering making it easier for these businesses to do business.
Tough just believe that entertainment in the city of Augusta needs to come into the modern era. I mean, when we're talking about, you know, folks coming in from out of town, we're talking about, you know, folks who are here in Augusta asking for certain venues, asking for certain things to do. I think that we shouldn't have a closed mind.
The city planning department bringing back a draft ordinance to a commission committee for adult nightclubs. The new rules would be less restrictive than current city code, addressing things like allowing more than one dancer on stage at a time.
I think that we need to be a little less restrictive, but we need to be a little more watchful. And I think that's where a lot of things have gone by the wayside.
As we go through some of these processes, whether it's adult entertainment or if it's somebody that wants to open up a restaurant downtown, I think that we need to make sure that we're being a business-friendly community.
Hey, it brings business down to Augusta, but it's a female commissioner, that's something I'm going to have to think about.
The new rules would still limit the clubs to areas zoned light industrial, meaning no new ones could open downtown.
I know that there's some conversation about downtown being home to strip clubs. My opinion about the zoning is whatever's best for the city, I'm willing to support.
The committee's vote is only a recommendation for the new adult dancing rules to take off. That will require approval from the full commission. In Augusta, George Escala, WJBF, News Channel 6.
A group of people from some Augusta neighborhoods is planning to hold a meeting to gauge interest in creating a new city within the Garden City. Local attorney Wright McLeod says they'll discuss the process for reincorporating the village of Somerville. It first came about back in 1861 when George Walton created large lots so people could build summer homes where it was cooler up on the hill. Now McLeod says some homeowners have become frustrated with the consolidated local government. They want it smaller and more efficient with reduced costs and better infrastructure.
The law requires them to go get a feasibility study at the cost of somewhere around $40,000, and the feasibility study will require that the committee determine or draw the boundaries.
A meeting will be held this Sunday at 6 p.m. at the Social Building on Elkton Court in Augusta.
It is time now for a first check of our weather.
And for that, we turn to meteorologist Jenna Petracci.
Well, it was a very cold morning with a low of 34 degrees. That's 5 degrees below our average, but we warmed up nicely today, made it to 71 degrees, which is actually well above average for this time of the year. So we've had nice warm weather, and we'll have mild conditions overnight tonight due to clouds moving into the area. But right now it's clear with temperatures in the low to mid 60s. We also have dry air in place still. Dew points are low and our winds are pretty light right now. So overall, pleasant night. Here's a look at our Terry Lambert Hyundai Skyview cam over in Aiken. Around midnight, though, will be when things change. We'll start to see more overcast skies, but right now it is pretty clear across satellite and radar. We're watching a strong storm system, though, bringing tornado warnings and severe storm warnings across Mississippi down to Louisiana, and a whole lot of lightning and heavy rain as well. So there's a closer look now. We had some Louisiana as well. So this system is still gaining strength and will impact Alabama and western Georgia as well with some strong severe weather. But for us, we aren't under a very high chance of severe weather. You can see that outlook for tonight extends into Atlanta with just a marginal risk. But for tomorrow morning, just a marginal risk as well for our western county. So that'll be anywhere from, say, Crawfordville down to Swainsboro, where there could be a strong wind gust. But other than that, really just the heavy rain concern, along with thunder and lightning for tomorrow morning. So keep that in mind when headed out the door to work or school tomorrow. You'll definitely need to be careful on the roads. It'll be very wet outside. Temperatures will be on the warmer side, though, in those mid to upper 50s. So clouds are increasing in the area tonight with widespread rain all the way tomorrow. A few strong storms are possible until the afternoon, and then we'll actually have clearing skies pretty quickly with some sun before the sun sets tomorrow evening. So coming up, I'll have a look at your forecast and everything you can expect for your Wednesday, but back to you, Jenny.
All right. Thank you, Jenna. Well, it may not feel like Christmas just yet, but some cities are already getting in the Christmas spirit. Tonight, Saluda is hosting its first Christmas tree lighting in some time.
News Channel 6's Nikita Dennis live in Saluda with that coverage for us. Nikita, what a great town. Saluda, South Carolina.
Yeah, you guys, in just a few minutes, this big Christmas tree sitting behind me will light up in front of the Saluda County Courthouse. And organizers tell me they haven't had a Christmas tree lighting event in many years, so this event will be very special. They will also have the Grinch that will come out to take pictures with kids, and there will also be dancers and music for you to enjoy. The city of Saluda will light the tree at 6:30 p.m. on South Main Street in downtown Saluda. And I also have the Grinch here that wants to say hi and Merry Christmas, and so I'll have more of you coming up on this story. And if you're in Saluda, you still have time to get down here to witness this amazing Christmas joy. Live in Saluda County, Nikita Dennis, WJBF, News Channel 6.
All right, Nikita, thanks. Let's go to North Augusta, South Carolina now, where they are getting set to light their tree as well.
That's right. Just a few minutes. We want to go ahead and take a live look now, and that's the John C. Calhoun Park, where people are gathered for the lighting of the tree.
Beautiful.
Looks pretty, doesn't it?
Yep. Great job out there, y'all. I'm in the spirit now.
There's live music, hot cocoa, marshmallow roasting, and all kinds of fun activities for folks to enjoy.
Runs until 7 o'clock tonight, so go out and look at that beautifully lit tree and enjoy all that North Augusta has to offer. Hey, you know, when you're doing your holiday shopping, you may hear bells ringing. News Channel 6's Hannah Latier tells us why putting some cash in those red kettles is more important than ever this year.
The Salvation Army's biggest fundraiser of the year is back and needs your support. All of the money raised from the Red Kettle Campaign goes toward people who are in need in the area. Officials told us they're falling behind on their goal of raising $225,000 this year. With prices going up this holiday season, the organization needs every penny and every volunteer they can get.
A huge part of the money that we raise this time of year helps us get through the drier months in the summer. And with the rising cost of food and all that, that affects us as well at the Center of Hope. And so that also, you know, we need as much as we can to be able to continue to feed. And we're averaging 190 meals a day.
You can sign up to be a bell ringer on the Salvation Army's website. And you can also donate using the new QR codes and credit card scanners on the kettles. In Augusta, Hannah Latier, WJBF News Channel 6.
All right, Hannah, thanks. Piedmont Augusta has named its new president and CEO. Dr. Lily Henson will replace James Davis as CEO. He's set to retire at the end of the year. Dr. Henson will begin the role on January 9th. She comes to Augusta after serving as the chief medical officer of Piedmont Henry.
Coming up, winter is coming in South Carolina.
How emergency management is preparing for the cold weather. First, though, a look at what's ahead tonight on News Nation.
Georgia is exactly 1 week away from the crucial runoff. That'll determine who's going to win the U.S. Senate seat in the Peach State. There's Raphael Warnock on the left. He's the Democratic nominee. He's also the incumbent for Herschel Walker, who is the other candidate in that one on the Republican side. You saw his photo. You know, former President Trump recently announced his 2024 presidential run. He's still going to take some time, though, he says, to help Walker through online fundraising.
President Trump has an extremely devout, loyal following, but that number is shrinking. He has nonpartisans who were attracted to his campaign and candidacy as far back as 2016, but is in decline, as witnessed by his endorsements failing so miserably in the primary and primary runoff.
President Trump says he has no plans to campaign in the Peach State for this runoff.
Well, this week marks Winter Preparedness Week in South Carolina weather-wise. At the State Emergency Operations Center, South Carolina leaders shared how they're getting ready. Officials say we're in a La Nina pattern, which means we'll be warmer and drier on average, but winter storms are possible. From mid to late January, we experienced three different weather events in the state.
Historically, seeing three major winter events in 3 weeks is incredibly rare. And this was one of the most active winter weather periods we've had in 10 to 15 years, despite the fact that it was a La Nina winter.
So to prepare, officials say make sure you have an emergency kit stocked up with food and water for up to 3 days and have your vehicle checked to ensure it's safe to use in winter weather.
Jenna joining us now for another check of our forecast.
Yeah, and speaking of strong storms, that's what we're watching now across Mississippi and the deep south. That's all with a cold front, and that'll drop our temperatures big time on Thursday. Upper 50s, low 60s on Friday, then back to the 70s next week. Coming up, I'll have a look at your feature cast, so stay with us.
Wow, if you're looking for great deals on Christmas decor, you've got to get to Carolina Pottery. Huge selections of ornaments, trees, wreaths, and greenery, all at our everyday low prices. Get festive for less this year. Visit CarolinaPottery.com or a store near you.
Wells Fargo.
$5.97 a month. Save big at Wilson Rubin Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram.
RideBaby.com.
Right now at Checkers, buy one big Buford, get a second one for just a dollar. It's like a movie with a sequel as good as the original. Except in this movie, the hero is made of perfectly seasoned 100% beef. And stacked with melty American cheese and the perfect toppings, all for just another dollar. Spoiler alert, the sequel is equally delicious and just a buck more. Buy one, get one for a dollar big Buford. You've earned it. Get Checkers delivered through our rewards app.
I'm all in.
Better life.
It's Christmas time again at Carolina Pottery. Shop and save on our variety of decorating themes. From traditional to whimsical, we've got the style you need with hundreds of value-priced products to choose from. Visit CarolinaPottery.com or a store near you.
Weather headlines on News Channel 6, brought to you by Jamie Casino Injury Attorneys. The Live 5x6 mobile app. Download it today. WJBF Live, 5x6.
Good evening. It was a beautiful, sunny Tuesday. We had warm temperatures as well. Now mostly clear skies, looking at our Terry Lambert Hyundai Skyview Cam in downtown Waynesboro. A pretty pleasant night, at least for now. 56 degrees, calm winds, dew point showing dry conditions, only in those upper 40s. Now this will all change shortly, though, as we will have some strong storms headed our way. But in the meantime, just the clouds starting to impact our western counties. You can see those cloudy icons. The rest of us are clear, anywhere from those mid-50s through low 60s for temperatures. 67, though, in Sandersville, still pretty warm. 64 in Wrightsville, Edgefield at 61, but only 57 now in Saluda, 58 in McCormick. So on satellite and radar, you can see the clouds approaching from the west. We're watching a very strong storm system unfold across the deep south. In particular, Mississippi and Louisiana dealing with several severe thunderstorm warnings and tornadoes, along with the heavy rain and even a lot of lightning. So notice our tornado watch in this red here. That's until 8 p.m. tonight, stretches as far east as just outside of Birmingham, Alabama. Over 10 different warnings happening here. The purple near Hattiesburg is a confirmed tornado. And these are some really large and long-lived tornadoes expected across Mississippi and Alabama the rest of this evening, where we're under a moderate risk of severe weather. And this severe weather outlook stretches all the way east into the Atlanta metro area for the rest of tonight. But as usual, when these fronts approach the East Coast, they definitely lose their intensity. So for the CSRA, early tomorrow morning, we are only under a marginal risk, and that's only from the Crawfordville area down to Swainsboro. So Augusta and Aiken and the surrounding areas not included under this risk, but nonetheless, still some heavy rain and gusty wind potential across the entire region. 8 o'clock tonight, that's when the system will really explode, packing a punch across northern Alabama into northern Georgia as well. By 6 a.m. Wednesday morning, you can see this line bowing out a little bit. That's where we have those gusty winds, most likely. Then by Wednesday evening, though, check this out. Clear skies, northerly winds, high pressure taking back over the area. So looking closer at home now, by midnight, spotty showers around with a southerly wind. That'll make for another warm day. And by 3 o'clock, that's when we'll see some heavy downpours in our northern counties around Washington, Lincolnton, and the leading edge of this storm will come through around 4 a.m., pushing through the metro south of I-20 by 6. And then our storm potential starts to go down by around the 8 o'clock hour. This is looking more just like rainfall, light to moderate rain, still pretty gusty, though, until around noon. And then we'll actually see those clouds start to clear. So since this is a fast-moving line of storms, we're not expecting a whole lot of rainfall, mostly only up to an inch of rain, but south of Augusta, more so under a quarter of an inch of rain. Also, once this passes, we'll have some really cold air moving in. So low of 52 tomorrow, then dropping down into those low to mid 30s for Thursday and Friday, then right back on track in the low 50s next week. Now for the next 10 days, we're seeing sunshine on Thursday. Just have to get through this very wet Wednesday morning. The weekend will be nice and warm once again as well, back to those low 70s, but it will be pretty cloudy all the way through next week. Now on to today's umbrella winner. That's Edward Hayes from Hepzibah. Congratulations, you have won a Viper 6 umbrella. Sign up to win on WJBF.com.
Jenna, thank you.
Thank you for that.
Coming up, girls flag football state playoffs.
And the U.S. playing to keep its World Cup hopes alive in sports.
Today I just yelled at the television and all. It was rocking. Yeah.
Well, it was a great day today. A lot of sunshine, but that changes tomorrow. We're tracking some heavy rain and storms moving in early tomorrow morning through the afternoon. Then back to sunshine and cooler temps Thursday.
All right. Thanks, Jenna. Thank you all for watching.